that a real place?
What? Oh no, this is a fake country.
Okay.
Are you kidding? If this was a real country, we'd have so much crap for this.
It just makes it barely illegal.
Well, it's actually one of the things that I really like about this, because it's like, okay, we can make anyone the bad guy here.
Even us?
Well, we're the SEALs.
Yeah.
We're not supposed to be the bad guys.
It's like, but you said you can make anyone the bad guy, so it's like,
well,
right.
I mean any country in these games. Body armor. Always, always, always body armor. Like, no matter what. It weighs quite a bit, but at the same time, like, it's body armor.
It's worth it.
In reality, like, the body armor...
Oh, I might be doing...
This is a stealth mission. In reality, the body armor stops, like, 2 to 3 rounds of the standard ammunition most militaries use. If... You know 50 BMG, the anti-material rifles? 50 cal, basically, right?
Yeah.
Standard body armor soldiers is given will stop one of those bullets.
Alright, is this one the worst one?
Oh, submachine... This... The MP5 is the best submachine in the game.
MP5?
This is the HK5, but in reality it's the MP5.
Okay, so...
HK is Heckler and Koch. It's the company. Because they didn't get the royalties to the HK weaponry, they just called the HK5. I also really love the music of this game.
I can't actually hear too well. If we raise it, then it'll be cut on the mic.
Actually not really, because of... This is a low quality mic. If you look over there on the computer, that's the audio right now.
Yeah.
And if we talk super loud, you can see it spike a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's really not picking up a whole lot. So I can go ahead and increase it.
Found the CIA operative codenamed Underwood near your present position.
Your computer or like your TV's so old. I still remember like that.
I remember way back when before we had the remotes. Okay, so we have a boat.
I will say, I actually have the same, like, old TV as you.
I just don't use it anymore. Right?
Well,
okay,
like,
recon.
I use it for my
GameCube. Recon. Basically, just look through your scope or binoculars at whatever target. So it says recon boat launch, just look at it with your scope. That's it.
A
little bit
to
the left. Yep,
we
there we go.
Find him and bring him
home. Yep, recon. HQ, we
found a camp and a handful of enemy forces. Is there a way to activate any, like, too heavily guarded. Stuff?
No, the binoculars is literally just... It's better magnification than scopes. That's all it is.
Okay.
Okay, don't go up there.
Where is the...
Don't bother with those yet. You'll get to those in time.
I gotta recon that.
No, turn around. There's a boat.
Yeah, I see that, but
just get to your objective, the closest one, trust me. Trust me on this.
Won't I fail the other one though?
If you do this stealthily, it shouldn't matter. If I remember correctly, you can recon them even after these guys in this area have spotted you.
Okay. If you say so, I just didn't want to lose that.
Let's be real here, after that first mission where you just straight up failed to recon because these idiots walked in the line of fire.
I didn't know that, like, they would stay in place, even though they, like, there's, like, pretty much, like, guys.
Okay, do not go straight over there. A little bit off to the right, there's a little, there's a little piece of land here. I suggest dropping off here and then circling around.
Oh, this is... I remember.
Okay, when it's the red dot, it's not he saw you, it's you saw him.
Oh, okay.
It's the thing over down in the bottom. You see there where it's the little rectangle next to your names?
Should I set them to fire at will again? Or no? Yeah, I'm not
caught. You could
yet.
Do fire at will, just go semi-auto. Semi-auto!
Tango ahead, sir!
Yeah. So. You know, not to get political or anything like that, but we had the Vegas shooting recently, where a weapon was used pretty much in full auto, right? My personal belief
which
is
shouldn't
that
shouldn't be
well,
acquired in the first place.
Actually, you can get your hands on them in the United States. It's just ridiculously hard, and they're usually in the tens of thousands for the price. Apparently, what the guy had was called a bump stock. I don't really know how it works, but it is used in conversion, and basically in converting a semi-auto to full-auto capabilities. Everything aside, though, my personal belief is that fully automatic weapons have no place in, like, even in law enforcement.
Oh, shoot, is that a guy?
Yeah, that's a guy. And here's my reasoning for this. You can see this right here. Wait, hold on. I think it's set on just straight up open door. They're not gonna breach.
Why?
Okay, there. Now it's set on breach.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, the icon's slightly different. So here's... Ooh! Frag!
But this will get rid of our stealth, but I kinda wanna do it.
Frag it! Frag it!
Let's do it, let's do it.
Frag you, mother fragger! So anyways, again, like, my personal thought is, like, practically, and in terms of, like, making people safer, I feel like fully automatic weapons have no place in, like, with people, like, with civilians, or with law enforcement. Like, I feel like fully automatic weapons have no place there. And, you know, the safety, it's pretty obvious, right? But in terms of law enforcement, you remember when we went to Airsoft?
Oh, yeah.
That place, that's not a door.
That looks like a door to me.
It looks like a door. That's gotten me before. So you remember when we went to Airsoft, that place is actually a place that law enforcement uses for training sometimes. It's what they do during the week, and it's why we had to schedule on a weekend. And one of the rules that they have there, and it's also a common rule for most training facilities, is when you're in the CQB, which is the close quarters combat stuff, like the shoot house, you are trained only to use semi-automatic. So, like, for the most part, the officers don't really train to use fully automatic. Same with the military. Like, your standard rifleman is trained to fire in semi-auto. Why? Because it's way more accurate. Like, the only guys who should really be firing in full auto are guys trained to do suppressive fire. And that's
which probably shouldn't be used for
It's not gonna. Well, I'm talking like with law enforcement and military. Because like the reason why I brought up airsoft is because that shoe house that we went to is used for law enforcement in addition to like airsoft. Like they do use it as a training ground. Which is one of the reasons why I was super hyped about going there. By the way.
You want to check out the area and stuff?
Well, not even just that. It's like, dude, actual law enforcement and military personnel use this place for training sometimes, and we get to go here. Like, how cool is that? You know? How cool is that?
I didn't actually even know about that.
It's on the website.
It makes me feel like a lot better than we did the preaching.
Well, that's why I sent you and Freeman the information. And Josh and Emma. It's why I sent you guys all the information on urban combat. Not that they read anything on it. No, there is intel here that you need to pick up, but not in this room.
Okay.
There is intel in this mission.
I cleared that out.
Yeah, so go back to the boat.
Oh yeah, zoom. Resume game is triangle.
It's okay. Here's the thing. Like, it used to be like that, you know, because PS2 and stuff like that.
Yeah.
When I switched over to PS3, it screwed me up so much, because, like, why is it circle? And then now I go back to the PS2 game, like, oh my god, it's triangle.
Yeah, once I get back home and
start just go
playing,
back to the boat, dude.
Yeah.
No, don't. Right. You take fall damage from that anyways.
I played Overwatch before I came here, and I just didn't jump around, so.
Yeah, but keep in mind, your health doesn't regenerate. I've never played Overwatch.
Your health doesn't... Okay. You have, like, medics for that.
Okay. Yeah, well, you have three medic.
The thing is,
dude.
You jump and there's no fall damage, that's why.
Oh.
Can you use this underwater? Yes.
Oh, no, you cannot fire underwater.
Oh, no, use your, night vision.
No. When you go into the water, it automatically goes to third person. Now, if you wait a quick second, hopefully your teammates will get into the goddamn boat.
I got
one. Also, notice how it's smoking a little bit, right? That's because you crashed in the land.
Oh yeah,
it took a little bit of damage. Just head to Delta. Anyway, so what I was gonna say about training earlier, when you were saying like, "Wow, I can't believe I can make those shots," and I was like, "You're a Navy SEAL." You remember what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
Last mission. So, Right?
Why would you do that?
Because that's not the path you're supposed to take. Okay, see the... Yeah, you see that little opening there?
Oh, this?
Right here? No, where the water is. Like, you see how you go towards...
This?
Yeah, you need
and
to
you
go...
You want to go around?
Go through that passage a little bit. Yeah, you need to go around.
Okay.
So you can keep using the boat to get there. So anyways. Again, soldiers are training semi-automatic. Okay? Like, with your standard M4 or M16, from what I know, you do not train full auto. A, is because it's more accurate, and B, because for the weapons qualification stuff and basic training, you're hitting targets at, like, 400 meters or so. To put that in perspective, a meter is pretty close to a yard, so one football field is about 100 meters. So, a standard soldier is trained to be able to engage at about four football fields away. That's pretty impressive.
I would say so. Like, for the most part, getting a headshot...
Okay, you're going to want to recon the watchtower from here. Just use your scope, honestly. It works with your scope, too. No, that's a tree.
I want the image. Okay.
Move up a little bit. No more. More. Just keep going.
Sorry, it's controller.
Okay, you see the tower there? Yeah. There, that's what you want to recon.
They've got a watchtower here, HQ.
There we go.
Looks like it's wired with an alarm as well.
Some new running gun.
Yeah. So, you know, full auto or burst fire, you have recoil, right?
Yeah.
Why in the world would you use burst fire at 200 meters?
How do you know we're here?
Oh, Jesus, you shot Killjoy!
Sorry, Killjoy, you had to take one for the team. He surprised me.
He didn't take any damage, which is good. Your teammates don't take any damage until you've hit them, like, a number of times, which is good, but it also introduces the problem of, like, oh my god, I was spamming because I was scared. Right?
In real life, that wouldn't fly.
Well, I mean, that's why I wear body armor.
Imagine, like, after a mission,
go up the ladder.
You
have to go inside.
Where's the ladder?
You have to go inside this watchtower.
Yeah, but where's the ladder?
It's up on the second floor.
Oh, yes, sir. Alright, boys, got breaches clear.
Okay, remember what I said about hitting L2?
What's that?
L2.
Oh, yeah, L2.
Yeah, that's faster.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm just letting you know. It's
but they only open the door.
Well, here. Look at it right now. That icon means breach.
Go there.
Yeah.
You got it. On my way.
I messed that up a bit.
Okay, board. Now turn and look at the door. Look at the door. That icon is open or closed.
Okay. Oh, so you have to look at the very bottom to actually see it.
Yeah. You have to look at the icon to see
what
it's doing. Yeah, that looked a little goofy, but you know what, whatever. It's a PS2 game.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not gonna do it.
I'm so disappointed that this game never got as popular as Call of Duty.
It's
now look, that's a sawmill over there. You need
because,
to
like,
on that.
Thing is, people don't really
no,
focus
turn.
On...
Don't jump off.
Yeah.
Do not jump off. Turn and look at the sawmill.
Sawmill?
You were literally just looking at it earlier.
Oh, right over here?
Yeah, just recon that.
HQ. Looks
okay,
like
good.
They're using this abandoned saw. Not
upstairs.
They've got power, so they must
ladder.
Have their own generator.
Ladder!
It's your room.
No, turn around!
You want me to go up here?
Yes, up the ladder.
Why?
You'll see.
Is there something up there?
There's a guy with an RPG up here.
Oh my god.
I'm kidding.
You're
it's a friendly.
Oh, just been I almost ringer. Forgot about you.
This is the first of
HQ.
Our SEALs. Yes,
team.
We have found a surviving member of the SEAL team.
Leave him on site and we'll send in an extraction
yep.
unit to get him out. Are you gonna follow me?
Automatically? No. No, he stays here.
Oh, okay.
If you had to escort him for the rest of the mission, it'd be too difficult.
Yeah, I imagine.
You'll leave him on site for additional operatives to come in and additional troops to come in and secure him.
Yeah, we're the good team. We deal with the actual difficult stuff. I almost immediately fell down as I said that.
Yep. Also, you can do a ladder slide. It's much faster.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. Like, why doesn't he do that? I have to do it automatically.
Yeah, you have to do it manually. God.
Coming up.
The most infuriating thing is you can't get off the ladder if there's someone in the hitbox for the ladder. Now turn.
I'm getting my bow.
Just swim there. It's fine. Just swim there.
Get my combat swimming going.
Combat side stroke. FTW.
Hey, just gonna stroll up in here.
Yep.
I just need some, like, there's no music going, like, as I'm swimming there.
Yeah, the menu music is what I really like. The rest of the music is, it's okay. it's okay. Also, when you come out of water, you are by default standing.
I wonder what the budget was.
Hold on, turn. You see the thing with smoke? That's a generator.
Oh.
You can turn off the power.
Sure, shoot it?
It takes, no, you have to actually go over there and turn it off. And as you would expect, it lowers their visibility by a little bit. Oh. Okay, so if you don't move the joystick at all for a little bit, it'll eventually steady. Nice.
Alright.
That looked like his neck instead of his head, but
yeah.
You know, whatever. Whatever. Video games. Video games.
There's no blood in this game, actually.
There is no blood.
Realize.
I think this is rated T.
Contact decided.
Get ready to. Is there any on here? I imagine.
Oh my god. Oh, that's right. Now I remember what I was going to talk about earlier. The three different enemy types. Oh, there's two. Oh, nice!
I didn't even realize but that.
Those are really fun to pull off. Anyways, yeah, there are three enemy types on this game. There is paramilitary, defense force, and mercenary. What you are up against right now are the lowest of the low, the paramilitary. You know, they're just basically standard nobodies who are getting trained as an unofficial military force. The defense force are actual trained military personnel, and the mercenaries are, well, mercenaries, right?
HQ, we've maintained stealth.
The AI for all of them
men.
Is, you know, it's at best, because... You know, that, like you can tell a lot of work and effort went into this game, but you can only get so far, right? The mercenaries, though, their accuracy is ludicrous. They'll go full auto and get a headshot on you from, like, 100 meters away.
Oh, shoot. No, I didn't realize.
It's fine. Everything is fine. It's fine.
I can't believe you just opened up that door, like, swung it open.
Yeah, that's how the doors open in this game. This room's clear.
Okay, yes. Yeah, you're my way over there.
Alright, team. Let's do this.
I wonder how the,
Nice.
Is he there?
Hold on, check the table real quick.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, never mind.
Yeah,
because, remember, you have to find intel. It's one of the primary objectives.
It's probably... Is it down below?
It's in one of these areas.
Is
hit select.
Oh, it's
go down to obtain Underwood's intel.
Down
also, do not drop down. You will take damage.
Even from this height?
Yes, even from this height.
Come on. This doesn't even look that high.
Okay.
If you're steady.
For a video game, it's not high at all. Realistically, you are falling an entire story.
Like, I've jumped an entire story, but I guess it's because they have a lot of stuff on them.
The amount of force that you're coming down with. Keep in mind, body armor weighs about 25 pounds. You have your primary weapon. Let's say you had all of your, let's say you still had all of your ammo, right? That's 5 additional magazines, about half a pound per mag. Then you have your handgun, and all the magazines for that. Then your radio, possibly frag grenades or med kits. You're coming up to like at least 50 pounds.
Oh yeah, if you move.
Yeah, yeah. Don't even bother with this. Just hitting them without the scope is fine.
I don't even know if I can reach them.
Mm-hmm.
They saw me.
Yeah, doesn't matter. You kill them. See?
Okay.
But yeah, the mercenaries in this game are ruthless. Because, like, they use military grade weaponry, right? Like.
Oh, I have a reload or something?
Oh! You're running low on ammo. Make your shots count. Yep. But yeah, the mercenaries in this game, they use like the standard 5.56x45 NATO, which is the ammunition that you're using right now. You can see how effective it is. Their handgun, they have the 5.7. Oh, you're hitting the wood, I think. Yeah, you're hitting the wood. That's bullshit.
Ah, how can you shoot me from right there?
Just step out. Like,
get out of my way, guys.
Oh, you also have to demo this. Move!
I like,
move.
Moving to the top left actually
destroyed the firing range and all the ammo.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry, my controllers aren't the best.
No, I know. It's just like,
you're prone.
I can't probably move like, okay, that was my fault completely.
Okay, so there's a little cabin off on your left. Left. Left!
I'm looking at my right though.
Yeah, go in there.
Why? I gotta kill these guys.
Because that's one of the possible locations for the intel.
Is he dead?
Yep. Go to the possible intel location.
Oh, he's running pretty fast, actually.
Yeah. That's another thing I'd like to point out. Oh, it's not here. I guess it's up there. Great.
Oh, wait. There is one down here.
No, it's... Those are possible locations.
Okay.
Because, like, realistically, why would you know exactly where it is, right?
For... Wait. Oh, right.
Yeah, it's just... I know it's around here somewhere.
Yeah, I see that a lot in video games where they have, like, possible...
Yep.
...places for that. I don't know, but, like, I... The one thing I will say that I do not like in video games...
Oh my god.
...is,
I just went prone for no reason.
I was trying to jump off this.
Yeah. That's what were you saying?
But,
you don't like...
I hate... Like, escort missions. They are pretty terrible. They're not really fun.
You're gonna have fun with the second to last mission.
Is it an escort mission?
Oh, God, is it an escort mission?
It's just kind of like, you know, like. Oh my gosh.
Switch to your handgun. Might be 9mm, but you know what? 9mm will do the job. AK-47.
Alright,
okay, so
I
oh, yeah, right there, on the barrel. You see it.
Why would you put that on the barrel?
Alright,
let's go.
So I want to point out that the AK-47... Exit.
Oh, is it done?
Yeah, you're done.
Okay.
I want to point out that the guy who made the AK-47 did not make any money. Like, he didn't get the rights to it. He didn't get to make a ton of money from it. Even though it is the most widely used firearm in the world.
I would say because the idea of it wasn't patented or anything.
Well, it's because he made it during the days of communism. You can't patent it.
So...
He does, however, have the rights to the AK-47 themed vodka bottle. But it's not the same.
Whoop-dee-doo.
Yeah, right? Like, you make the most legendary rifle in, like, basically all of history so far, right? And you don't get... It, like, you know, he gets paid by the communist state, right?
Yeah.
He gets paid by the Soviet Union.
But he gets paid, like, similar amounts to...
Yeah, it's, you know, it's communist. Next.
19%?
Next!
He got 25? The heck?
Oh, sick burn!
Dude, I got more kills though. He only got one. That's why he had 25%, because he only killed one person.
Yeah. I fired 4 shots and one of them was a headshot. That's a good KD ratio, right? 1-1? So there are medals you can get in this game. It's basically like, you know, achievements and stuff like that. And the more medals you get, the more stuff you unlock.
Oh, will I be able to upgrade from Private Idiot?
Private Idiot? Sergeant Idiot? No. No, you don't get to rank up. I will tell you this right now. I got an 90% accuracy rating.
Yeah, you were using a sniper rifle or something?
I was using an M16.
No.